Morning. This is Troy from the do-it-yourself world and the off-grid project. Sorry, forgive me while I try to adjust my headband. This is something new for me. I'm going to attempt to drive. I'm trying to drive my truck. I'm in two-wheel drive right now. And see how this goes with the action cam on my face. It's not very comfortable. I might need to get a different thing. So I'm not parked in my meadow. You may have noticed just now. I'm not parked at my place. I'm parked in the meadow before it. The snow here is pretty high, as you can see. It's a very narrow path here to get through. I'm going to help a friend finish his move. That's the move we started last week. I'm going to help him finish it right now. That's the plan. I don't think my door is latched. Is it? No, my door isn't shut. Old truck. So anyway, here we go. It's gonna be 40 degrees today, so the slop is melting away. One slop is being replaced by another. We're gonna have some serious melting and mud going on here pretty soon. Creek is froze up still. Thinking about doing some ice fishing before it's too late. Get out here and see if I can get some perch. There's perch up here in the water. I want to try that out. Garbage cans are still here. They're not picking them up. Well, heading off. My friend has nobody else to help. I've got a truck and broken rib or not, I've got to do it. Can't leave people hanging, so here we go. This is Saturday. Heading away from the off-grid homestead for the day. Figured I'd take you with me. I promised you I'd do some more video. I promised now that I have the action camera, I would take it with me more often. And so here we go. Now I'm going to pause until we get up to some beautiful terrain up here in a while. I'll see you guys in a bit. It's passing the Watchtower Farms. Talk about preparedness. These guys are prepared. You can learn a lot from them. They've got their own, you can almost see it out there. They've got their own farms, their own food packaging and food processing plants. Everything. These guys, they're prepared. At Watchtower Farms here, they've got their own printing shop. They do their own magazines and newspapers. Now, I'm not promoting them. I'm talking about preparedness. I don't exactly agree with everything they talk about, but that's not a discussion for this video. But what's important is the preparedness aspect of it. They're completely self-sufficient. Completely, absolutely self-sufficient. Got their own fields and food processing and packing and storage. That's some people you can learn from. Some other groups you can learn a lot from is the Mennonites. They're pretty self-sufficient too. Some of them use power, some don't. And then in Pennsylvania, you got the, of course my brain shuts down. The people riding around in their horse-drawn buggy. Of course, can't think of them right now. But anyway, they're self-sufficient. Most of them don't use power. If they do, it's a wind turbine. I've seen wind turbines. but there's some rich farms up in this area. Really rich. Big farms in New York, upstate New York. There's the view I was mentioning. Hold on, right there, that view. View of the Gunks, the shawangunk Mountains. A lot of snow out here. Whole lot of snow. In some places it's really piled up. I love the country. Some people seem to think I was a city boy. I don't know where they get the idea. I grew up in the country. I love the country. I make mistakes. I make a lot of mistakes, but doesn't mean I'm a city boy. I prefer the country any day over the city. I lived in New York City a while and I got out as soon as I could. Not for me. Here's a nice view. Thought I'd share that with you. Coming up over this hill. A lot of hills and mountains out here. But I'm pretty much leaving the biggest of the mountains behind me right now. They're right behind my house. That's a beautiful home. I like the old style homes like that. I'll never have one. I'm happy to have a tiny house. I want to show you another pretty sight we're coming up on here. The Wallkill River. It's froze over right now. That's an old rusty water tower. Right there. There's the dam. I don't know if they produce power here. I think that's a hydro plant, possibly. But there's a dam there. That's pretty in summer. Well, there's a nice view of the mountains. Right back there is where I live, up against the foot of the mountains. My friend is out over this way. Show you a nice, oh, there's the prisons. That's not so nice. Wallkill and the shawangunk prison. Well, at least they got a good view at the times they do get to look outside. But it sure is a nice place, especially coming up from a flat area like Michigan. Really flat. Now my door isn't shut. I went and stopped and got coffee on the road, and now my door isn't shut tight. That's the thing with the truck. There's vacuum in the cab. The old trucks especially, it's hard to slam these doors properly. Something else of interest, this big bump right here. That's the New York City Aqueduct. Now, I didn't believe it when I first saw the numbers, but there's a pipe right there. Runs out from the country all the way 120 miles over to New York City. Pumps 9 billion gallons of water a day to the city. New York City prides itself on having some of the cleanest water of any city in America. That's pure, clean, coming from the runoff from the mountains up north. And the lakes and the streams and the ponds up here. Here they're building some substation for the aqueduct. Well, I'm almost there, so I'll see you guys when we're working later on. Speaking of the aqueduct, I have a problem. I have a serious problem. This is really frustrating. trying to get onto the aqueduct, crossing it on pure ice. I had to run up onto the highway, trying to back in because the driveway to my friend's house is so narrow and winding, you cannot turn around once you're in the yard, and we have to load the truck with his gear. Anyway, I had to run across the highway, put in reverse, and run at high speed to get up this hill. And at high speed, slipped sideways, ran into this deep snowbank, and here I am. Four-wheel drive is not going to help me now. Now I need a shovel, so I'm waiting on my friend to bring me his shovel. Fun, fun, fun. This is the stuff you don't see every day. It's just action camera. Gonna keep it with me from now on and show you everything, the good and the bad. And this is what happens in this winter area. I had it in two-wheel drive. I tried to make it up this really steep. It's a steep, I don't know if you can see the drop. It's really steep. I could not get it up there. Tried at real high speed because I was in reverse. Of course, in reverse at high speed, you don't have as good a control of your vehicle. And here I am. Yep. Here I am. Now at least it's warm out. It's a nice day. Oh, that one's really heavy. Well, I'm carrying these boxes. Obviously, I can't take the heavy ones. Nobody would help. It's just me and my friend doing this move. Just the two of us. I'll just have to take it easy in the following weeks and recover from this. But we'll get it done. We'll get it done. That's about 32 degrees. It's not too bad today for a move. At least it's not snowing like it was last time. Get all this stuff up there. Oh. Got a lot to do. There's so much here. Oh, what a job. Alright. These aren't so bad on my rib. I'm basically resting it on my leg as I walk. Takes most of the strain off. That furniture, that's the hard stuff. That furniture is no fun. Not at all. We'll fill this truck up. Fill it up high, and then strap it down and head out. Got some chairs. We're really filling up the truck high, but we got a tarp and tie-down strap, so it's gonna be all right. Winter moves. Not the greatest time for a move, but that's what we got. I'm gonna try to work these chairs onto here somewhere. How high we go. It's a truck. As long as everything locks in and we can tarp it down afterwards. What we got here? I'm sure that'll fit. Yeah, here we go. Around that. These are some good old made in Japan. I got these for him. This is that trip I got for free that one day and gave to my friend. These were those chairs. They're really good quality, I think. This one was broke but fixed, but they were really good. Authentic furniture products from Japan. Well, there it is. The last of the gear. Load it up. We did it. Tonight I'm going to be hurting, but we did it. We got it done. You know who your friends are when it comes time to move and everybody says, oh, I'm tired, oh, I'm lazy, oh, I'm bored. He had to do his move and we had to get it done regardless. Nobody else wanted to help. And that's the last trip. That's it, we did it. Good old truck comes through again. I love my old truck. It's a workhorse. I got buried in there pretty deep. I hope that shows up well. I was up to the frame. I was buried to the frame in that snow. Well, we got it out earlier and then kept on going and did the job. So, heading home. Well, I gotta unlock the hubs. See that hill? It doesn't look like much on camera, probably, but that's a killer. It all thawed out today, so that's convenient, but that was a killer this morning when it all iced up. The old school four-wheel drive, manual locking hubs. But I like old school. Old school is reliable. Clean this truck out. We trashed it today. Well, we did it. I was in some serious pain earlier, but we did it. Put this back in two-wheel. Hi. And head home. Oof, come on now. Slipping a little bit. Finally, I want to go home and rest. That was a day. What time is it? 5:30. It was a whole day. Full day. Well, we did it. We did the entire move. Well, it's good to help friends. And it's good to really help each other when they need it. Enjoying a cup of coffee after a hard day of work in the cold. Loving my coffee. Ah, look at that. What's that say? It's only a dollar for that thing. Well, going home. I think I'm just going to relax tonight. I'll see you guys later. Just want to show you the scenery here. That mountain view. Hopefully it comes into view here in a minute. I'm also testing the camera right now in a little bit dimmer light. Try it out in different light situations. Wonder if that shows up. Snow-topped mountains over there. It's just quite pretty. This will be another good test of the camera's capabilities and see if you can see that, the snow on the mountains up there in the distance. It's convenient driving with a head camera because now nobody can yell at me for not having my hands on the wheel or for not paying attention to what I'm doing. Pause the camera until we got up to the top of this hill up here. It's a really nice view up here. So there's my mountain. there it is. It's a nice little view. Hope that shows up. This is really a good test of the camera. As I said a minute ago, good test of its capabilities. See what everything looks like in the dimming light. Wow, the roads are getting bad this winter. Truck bucks like a mad horse. This winter was pretty rough on a lot of these roads. Well, heading home. Well, coming back to the homestead. There's my lake. A pretty lake. Oh, there's a deer. You see the deer in the lake? Right outside there? Oops, I thought it was in a stall. He's just sitting here looking at me. He's sitting out there in the ice. Oh, there's some more. Oops, I stalled. Back up a minute. Oh, maybe I won't back up. I'm in two-wheel drive. See all the deer out there? One, two, three. Yep, there's three there. There's a big one right there. Four deer right there. Wasn't going back up that hill in two-wheel drive. Not with these tires. It's starting to ice back up. It melted a little today. And now it's starting to ice back up. There's where the garbage cans sit all winter. People occasionally move them, but the garbage man doesn't come down the lane anymore. That's it. Well, spring is coming. It's supposed to be warmer this week, so this will all melt. If I'm gonna do some ice fishing, I better get to it sometime soon here. There won't be any more ice. The fish seem to be dormant then. And there's my creek. That's why I haven't been able to hear. People keep asking why have I not been working on my water system in the house. Well, there's my water supply. You can't really get to it safely anymore. So actually I've got water jugs right here next to me from my friend's place. When I was helping him move, I took some empty jugs and filled them up. Right now it's a matter of get it where you can, get it when you can, because that creek, I'm not going over that anytime soon. Walk out over that on an ice ledge and fall through into 6 foot of ice water? Nope. Not for me. Right there is where I usually go down. Man, it's starting to thaw a little bit. But it's still dangerous, I think. I'm not going near it anytime soon. It's just not safe. Oh yeah, this is starting to ice up now. You can hear it crunching. Quite the tunnel here, or trenches, I should say. It's gonna take a while for that to thaw out. Now, I remember last year I came home around this period and there was about half this much snow on the ground. Yeah, it was just around this time period I came home last year from Australia. Whoa, ho, ho, pure ice. Ah, I might have to put it in four just to park it. See if I can run it. Come on, old truck. There you go, there you go. Oh, we're slipping on ice. Made it home. Back to the off-grid homestead. Tonight, I'm sore. I tell you, when you find out who your friends really are, when it comes time to move, and the only guy there is injured, and the rest of them have excuses. But, well, it's done. Now, I want to go into the tiny house and chill.